I'm Debbie Birch, and I'm with the Queen Anne's County Office of Tourism, and we're here today to talk about an annual event. Happens every year, and it's been going on for quite a long time. It's Kent Island Day. Happens down in Stevensville in the historic district downtown, and I have Jack Broderick here. He's dressed the part for the event. So tell us a little bit about it. Welcome, Jack.
Well, thank you, Debbie. It's great to be here. Nice to be able to do this.
I'm excited. It's May 16th. What's that, the weekend after Mother's Day?
It is, in between Mother's Day and Memorial Day.
Yep, there we go.
But each year, third Saturday in May, we celebrate Kent Island Day. A very special day for Kent Island, which we feel is a very special place. You know, Kent Island was actually the settlement there, the third English permanent settlement in the U.S.
Yeah, ahead of St.
Mary's. After Plymouth, Jamestown and Plymouth Rock.
Right.
Yeah, there was an issue there. 1631 is when Kent Island was established. That was 3 years before Maryland. Mm-hmm. And so there was a bit of a political problem
right.
with Lord Baltimore and the Maryland folks. And they eventually won out. So they, you know, in history, the winners get the right to history. So Kent Island was kind of written out of the whole Maryland
right.
scene until fairly recently. And you know, the Kent Island Heritage Society was founded in 1975 to discover, identify, restore, and preserve the history and heritage of the island. And part of that is to celebrate that history and heritage. And that's what we do every year
right.
In May.
And it's a nice event. It's a family-oriented event.
Yes, it
and
is.
You actually close the streets down, and you have a parade.
Yep.
That goes through the town, and then tell us about some of the vendors or what people can expect if they come to it.
I'll mention the overall thing. We do close all of Stevensville. We get the okay from the sheriff, the state police, and the state highway guys, and we put up barricades. So that becomes our fairgrounds, you might say,
right.
our parade ground and
right.
community event. And it's great. It's if you ever watch the old Andy Griffith shows, Mayberry, it's kind of like Stevensville, you know. I mean, it's our local Mayberry on Kent Island. It's a very homey hometown, great place for a community event. And we started off with a special opening ceremony in town, 10 o'clock. And then at 10:30, the parade kicks off from Kent Island Elementary School.
Okay.
Comes down into town and then circles up to Church Street. But everybody... Most of the people stay right in town after the parade.
Right.
And it's great. It's, the local fire department, police departments, marching bands from the schools, antique cars, antique people.
antique people. I love it.
Kids.
You covered it all.
Scouts. horses. It's great. It's a neat hometown parade. And we've always got room in a parade for people that come and march and wave and enjoy it. I love a parade myself, and I just enjoy it.
And after the parade's over, though, there's a lot to see and do. So, you know,
sure
it's not just like you're going to a parade. You're staying for the whole event.
Well, yes. And we've got great food there. Doug Ward and his folks from It's the Pits
mm-hmm.
are
Excellent.
Set up with all the good stuff that those guys do, and it's great. And then we have some... hot dogs and hamburgers and ice cream and lots of other good local food. Last year we just about ran out of some stuff, so
wow.
you know, we had a good,
it was
really
a nice
good crowd
day last year too.
Everything tasted
yeah.
great. It was just perfect. But we have all of our historic sites open.
Mm-hmm.
As you mentioned, it is an arts and entertainment district. We got a number of great shops, artists in there,
right.
and. Really neat historic venues that we have restored and preserved. The old post office, the historic bank, the Cray House, 200-year-old early American home right in the middle
right.
of Stevensville, completely restored inside and out. It's a living museum, really.
Mm-hmm.
The old train station and an old caboose.
And
they all have docents in there. So
right.
they are open exhibits as part of the day, and you can wander in and out of all of those.
And I have to say, if you've never been in any of those, the one I find fascinating is the bank. And in the back of the bank, the artifacts and information that's in the bank is unbelievable.
It's great. It's a little museum
yes.
set up in the back room the old boardroom of the bank.
Right, right.
And we've got some Native American artifacts, some old medical artifacts, decoys, military uniforms and paraphernalia from local Kent Island veterans. It's a neat little mini museum.
Mm-hmm. It is.
And outside we have a number of other venues and vendors. A lot of stuff for kids, face painting, kids crafts, pony rides, a balloon bounce.
Nice.
So kids, parents can bring their kids and really expect the kids to enjoy it.
So it is. It is a family event.
It is.
You have music too, right?
We do. We have the stage set up in the pocket park next to the bank.
Okay.
And we'll have music, the Mattapique Middle School Jazz Band.
Okay.
The Sweet Adeline Chorus, Kent Island Youth Choir, and a couple of dance groups.
Very good.
The Shield School of Dancing right in town there, and then the Kent Island Dance Connection will all be performing at various times during the day. And we'll have that information out in the local papers and on our websites, exactly the time
the whole
when
schedule,
they'll
so
be
people.
Performing.
And the time, it starts at 10:30?
The overall event starts at 10.
Okay.
But the parade starts at 10:30 and then comes down.
And then it runs
town.
To?
And music is starts at noon. And it runs till about 4:30.
Okay.
5 o'clock is the official time, but most folks are heading out by that time. But it's a wonderful hometown event.
And there's no charge for coming and strolling through the town and, you know, of course, food and vendors. But, you know, you can come listen to the music, sit there, and enjoy the day.
Yep, you sure can. So it's a great day. It's a good free day with your family. Learn
right.
some things and have fun. And usually it's a nice spring day, and we always cross our fingers on the weather.
Knocking on wood.
But a great time to be out and celebrate what Kent Island is all about.
Right. So it's Saturday, May 16th, and you just come, and, you know, there's tons of parking around. You can park at the schools and walk into town, so there's plenty of parking in the area. And come out and enjoy the day. So, well, Jack, thank you.
Look forward to seeing all of our Kent Island friends and friends
and
from all around the area, both shores. It'd be a great day, and we look forward to seeing it.
And
everybody.
The website is for the Heritage Society. It's KentIslandHeritageSociety.org.
Yes,
so if you want to see more information or if you're interested in being a vendor, go to the website, and they have applications right on there you can download.
They
so.
Sure do, or if you want to be in the parade.
There you go. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you, Debbie. Look forward to seeing everybody there.